Hi, my name is Isaac Gish, and I need two volunteers from the audience. Scott and Joe. Alright, Joe. I'm going to ask you a question about the slide I'm about to show you, and you say the first thing that pops into your head. What color is this?
Green.
Alright, Scott. What color is this?
Blue.
Alright, you're finished.
Woo!
So, you can see these slides and say that they're blue, or green, or red. It really doesn't matter except for the fact that people have different perspectives on every single thing in this world. Every single thing. Now I'm going to tell you a story. A story about a man named Lorenzo. Lorenzo was the former CEO of the company, and he had a good life. Until he walked away from everything. And he describes this moment as a four-year process that can only be described as losing his identity. It was a time frame where he would shift in and out of homelessness and heartbreak. He lived in his car and was ashamed of who he was. He knew his name, Lorenzo, but who exactly was that? Without knowing who he was, he couldn't socialize with anyone. His social standpoint on himself was that he was just trash. So after reading this part of the story, it got me thinking, what exactly is the definition of identity? So I looked it up on Google and here's what I got. The fact of being who or what a person or thing is. That's just talking itself in circles. It doesn't actually give you a true definition. So I moved on to the second one. And it said, a close similarity or affinity. I didn't even think those words belong in the same sentence together. So after thinking some more, doing some more research, I decided to boil down the fact of identity to one question. Who am I? So Lorenz goes on in his story to really define what identity is. He says it's not just knowing who you are, but when you lose your identity, you are so focused on what the outside world thinks about you that your own self-worth deteriorates. He concludes his story by recognizing that he wanted external recognition, and that if you don't know yourself, how in this terrible, suffering, ungrateful world could you ever be happy? So ladies and gentlemen, I want you to see this point. People live their lives believing that they will never be enough. As you can see in Lorenzo's story, he thought that because he had given up on who he was, he could never be enough. They think that to be themselves, their very own identity, is the very worst thing in the world. People have been hurt and shamed by the thoughts that this world put into people's minds. Thoughts like, I'm no good. Thoughts like, I'm not rich enough. Thoughts like, I'm not important. Thoughts like, no one cares about me. Thoughts that started as seeds and grew and grew and grew and grew and grew. And it's something that cannot be uprooted by your own strength. Like the young girl who wishes to be someone other than herself because of what someone did to her. Like the young boy who wishes to be something or someone else because he believes he doesn't measure up to what a guy should be. The world poisons our minds and dwindles our self-identity by use of media and celebrities. Into a shell that is programmed to protect us from reality. So you might ask me, how do I determine my identity? I would tell you, it's not based on a feeling, it's not based on self-worth, and it's not changed by past experiences. May I submit to you that there is a God who is creator. He created all of us on purpose and did not make a mistake. To find the most fulfillment in your life, find peace in your heart, and to find hope for the best you, I encourage you to embrace the God who created you, because He is ready to embrace you.